Hey guys, Dr. Prometheus here, back with another episode of our Grand Tactician 1861 spring campaign, and I've kind of been fooling around with this for a couple of hours. I had to redo the dev portion, uninstall, reinstall type deal from the patch they just put out to the next the new dev patch. And it fixed the cavalry issue I was having here. This was coming out white, so it fixed that graphic. I reverted back, and it broke my save, as in the point that the Confederacy wasn't moving. I fast-forwarded about a month and a half, and the Confederates actually attacked me at DC. So from here, it should be at least working. Keyword, it should. So go through the military, I've named some military units, and we're going to recruit some as well, because we are trailing them heavily. Not a good sign. We'll start with the Department of the West, Sir Churchill, and the Missouri Brigade, 1st Brigade, Hawkins. Some of these aren't named. We have Old Abe, 8th Wisconsin Volunteers. Some of these, I'm going to shorten the names because some of the stuff kind of messes up. So, 8th Wisconsin. I didn't do any of the batteries here. From here, this is the Dirty First, or the 31st Illinois. Here, under Napoleon J.T. Dana. Then we have McNulty, U.S. Those Wabe Cadets out of Illinois. This was a real unit here under Caleb McNulty. Reno has the 2nd U.S. Sharpshooters, the 21st Ohio Infantry under Mower. Craig has the Loyal Lincoln Volunteers. De Trebond hasn't been named yet. I kept some of these blank in case. Be the Orphan Brigade or the 1st Kentucky. And then with Miller, we have the 5th Brigade. One thing I do want to put here is a cavalry portion. I want to put some scouting cav, at least one. Craig Irving, not something big, but just the fact that I need type of. Okay. For scouting purposes. John Reynolds will take over the 1st cap here, our Department of the West. Got garrisons under the Army of the Tennessee under Grant of Edwin V. Sumner. Thomas H. Hill has an unnamed brigade. The 2nd Brigade here in Shrubner with the Connecticut. So these haven't been named yet. Under Mansfield, we got James Rorty, Tyler, and Nelson Tyler. These haven't been named yet. I have all of these named. I think this was when I was in the middle of naming them, actually. Last night I had some issues. Hey, it happens. Yeah, we had some issues with that. So, we did have a comment from CJ Huntsinger, who is in the National Guard, and his unit heritage goes to the 111th Pennsylvania. I'm guessing infantry. So you're going to be under John F. Reynolds, under Hooker's First Corps. With that, actually, it's going to be Hooker's Fourth Corps. We do have that. And so that has been added with this. Let's put a couple of more names as we kind of go through. We'll do a couple more each episode. If you guys have any suggestions, go ahead and let me know. Open this up before. These were the Nashville Union Guards. And under them was York Boys. Let's go with moved all the Pennsylvania units over here. I'm looking through it. There. Tennessee Volunteers. Resources. Okay, so yeah, we didn't have a name for this one. Let's go with hell. Ooh, Ward's Raiders. That looks good. For these, we have the 13th. Adolphus here is going to be the 8th. PA Reserves. I'm not sure what's going to happen here with these. I did have an issue where they were able to go into negative time. If that happens, we will merge these and we will recruit four more units, then merge these into other units in that way. Let's go through the Army of the Potomac right quick. I do have some other names that we can do as we go through. So, under Meade's Corps with the 3rd Corps, under John Pope, we have the 13th PA Reserves, 8th PA Reserves, and the 1st PA Reserves. With Wycoop's brigade here. Under Winfield S. Hancock, you have the U.S. Sharpshooters, the West Virginia, the Excelsior Rifles, Nashville Union Guards, and Ward's Raiders. We haven't done anything with the artillery. The U.S. 1st U.S. Cavalry, Lightning Brigade, and 2nd Mass Cavalry under Barker. Sorry, cough there, kind of. Under Crittenden, well, the 1st New Jersey Infantry, which are 3-month troops. Philadelphia Brigade, which is 3-month troops. Eastern Shore, 1st Maryland, the 3-month troops. And we have the 1st Vermont Old Brigade. Because we're going to make it like this. We see the Old Brigade, 1st Vermont, kind of go like that. But because there is some weird issues. That was already like that. Okay. The 4th U.S. Cavalry is under Buford now. Under Sherman. Under Palmer. Sullivan has the Parnell Legion. Maryland Cavalry. Under Robertson, we have the 8th U.S. Cavalry. Wool, the last division, actually was technically the 1st division of Sherman's corps. Matthews has the Iron Brigade. We had to fudge it out of Ohio. That's cool. I know they were Wisconsin and Michigan boys. I think a couple of Indiana regiments as well. Then we have the Gibraltar Brigade, which was the 8th Ohio. There under McQuaid. Hazard as the 1st Tennessee Volunteers. One, the 69th New York Volunteers under Burge. Then we go into Reynolds. We have Dury Zouaves. I think I'm pronouncing that right. Which is known as the 5th New York. This is a real-life commander, I believe, that commanded this corps. Arnold has the Bucktails. I know they were from New York, but we're going to fudge it and have them out of Rhode Island. Joshua Chamberlain has the 20th Maine. Martin James has the Rochester Racehorses, otherwise known as the 140th New York Infantry. And then Buchanan there, the one we just added with the 111th Maine under Robert Buchanan. Under Daniel Tyler, we'll have Keyes commanding the Connecticut Regulars. Schnick has the Fighting Fools, which are also known as the 8th Ohio Volunteers. Of them, 8th Ohio as well. The Irish Brigade under Oliver, and Richardson has its own brigade, which is supposed to be 24th MI Militia. We haven't done anything with Gibbon and the artillery. We have George Custer with the Cavalry Division under Hooker. With the 1st Cav, 2nd Cav, we haven't named those. Army of the Ohio. We have Patterson here. We're going to have this one be Wildcat, otherwise known as the 105th Pennsylvania Volunteers for Elbert. Our next one under that, we're not going to name the one for Hunt. Smith, going to be one from Pennsylvania again. This is going to be the 47th Pennsylvania Infantry. I'm using some of these blank in case you guys want to name them. We don't have anything for the Cav. We go over here to Duval, the Bloody 7th Virginia. We recruit them out of West Virginia, but it'll work. Gilroy has the Indiana Brigade. And this one from Massachusetts will be the 3rd Battalion Massachusetts Rifles. Department of the West, the Missouri Brigade, 1st Brigade, 2nd Brigade, and Old Abe's 8th Wisconsin. Kind of already went through Dana and McNulty, Sharpshooters, 21st Ohio, Little Lincoln Volunteers. I didn't have anything for Iowa. We have the Orphan Brigade. This one here. Under McNeil, or under Neil, this is Indiana. This is going to be the 27th Indiana Infantry. And the next one under Schreiber is going to be the 20th Indiana. Duncan, we didn't have to name that. Over here with Rowley, that's one with Illinois. And this one is going to be the 70th Indiana. So yeah, if you have any other ones, if you like to add, go ahead and let me know. We'll kind of add them as we go through. We might have an issue when we do the U.S. Colored Troops. Possibly. I have no idea. But as of right now, we have a deficit to make up. And fielded? I don't think that is true. 31,000? I guess that's true. We don't have a full portion. These are all 3-month volunteers. So under Pope, let's grab some from New York. One more under Rowley. Mountain Department. Get some did a couple things of cavalry. Mountain Department. 14,000 on the Potomac. That one out west is going to be difficult. Okay, let's see. We'll do a blockade stance. On that port, okay. War's at destination. Down to Vernon. Connecticut. Go all the way out to Pittsburgh. Let's stop. Grant, I want him to stop just before. I had an issue where he came down here and then got on the river and then did some thing down here and came down. I want him to stop down near Cairo. Want to actually stop at the port. Cairo, the city's around here. So I'm going to have to stop like. Okay. Because I need to get supplies set up here. Let's, I kind of want to see our supply lines. Arnie is holding that. If 22,000, we only have 8 on hand there. We have 6,000 there. We have 5,000 there. Okay. This is rough. That's going to create another army, and the worst part about it is, at least in the patch I was working with, kind of buggy. Fleet at Iro, Illinois. Henry Bell is going to take command of it. Frigates. Briggs. What we're essentially doing is we want a large fleet. The thing I do want to do is I want to look over armies. Musket. Oh, cool. Yes, finally tells me how many there are. Villa Renz. Renz is that goes up over time. Guilds. Carbines. 200 yards. Maynard's are 3. Over here. Cavill use burn sights. That just makes sense. Rifles. The biggest thing is we just don't have men on hand, I think. Biggest issue. Men on hand are going to be major, major. We'll be able to get majority of our forces better rifles. Is the key. Is what we've been saving for. Literally, we've been saving for that. These are just import onlys right now. Not like we can get anything else. One would be an ordnance rifle. One would be a parrot rifle. The one that's going to be a 20-pound parrot rifle. The large howitzer in there. Get 130-pounder. That one will be. Keep that there, like that. Two. Seven. Let's see if they're recruiting more and more. Okay, they are. So it's working fine. Okay, let's. I want to put those into the Army of the Potomac. Did it finish? Okay, it finished. Did I not get an additional army? Or is it just recruits now? Add them somewhere. Did the vent not fire? It will be added to Union armies immediately. There they are. Take a second for them to spawn. Okay. So this other one will be commanded. Pencilman. Lynn. Howard. Listen. First corner, Heinzelman's gonna go over here. Gonna number this properly. First core. Okay. He's at 73. Oh, he's still not moving. Not moving anything again. I break this again. Oh, 87,000. He's still recruiting. Still recruiting. Know what I'm gonna do with this? Going to be Show me the golf. Eventually, this is the one that's going to go south. Put them over here. Hold the peninsula here. And maybe we do a peninsula campaign, maybe we don't. Okay. Not moving. They are recruiting now. Oh, they attacked us. The Battle of St. Louis. Okay. We have fixed it. Ladies and gentlemen, we have fixed it. Let's go into our first battle. Going up against Major General Price. If we win this, we're going to push more into Missouri or Springfield. Our army will vigorously attack the enemy. But we were attacked. Why would we vigorously? We're already here. All men, long range. Get it down to the men. March to the first objective. Oh, wow. They have defenses. We're going to swing around and hit them from the right. Once we get there, we will form battle line. You can see off in the distance fortifications or a battle line on the hill. Amen. We must do this in an organized manner, otherwise we will lose this. Which means I must come at them from a flank. Do you have a better morale? Then, form a line. My other video, I actually defended even the same map. I defended here against their attacks. Crazy. Okay. Arnie. Man up. Man up. Not see them in their fortifications. And move up. Sixteen hundred, we do not see the enemy in their fortifications. Things seems off. Move up. Men, far side now. We're going to occupy the defenses. Danfavs with the reserve behind it. There's some narrow areas we can cross the river. We're going to have to watch our back. They're moving up towards Wire Road. Situated probably around May. Fire department. Long range. Sure, everyone is on long range. Between the loyal Lincoln volunteers here. My guess is they're going to come right up the main road. Now here they come. They're going to start forming a line. Wolf's Brigade out in front, Sheffield, Gordon, Rogue. Not need anyone on our right flank, I don't think. Actually, it might be beneficial to have Craig on our extreme right. Let's do it. Oops. Left. Here, this one, okay. Now we wait for the attack. Here we go. They've come in range of the troops. And their defenses. They took up the defensive areas around Edward's cabin. Have it, men. I think that is a tad too loud. Confederates is just not lined up to give any attack. I'm trying to get together. Men, for the medium range, you're going to run out of ammunition at this rate. Before the attack. They're giving it long range. There we go. I'm trying to peek at our rear. recruit back their spot. Hold strong, boys. Mr. Rebel's back. I can fire it on the flank, so let's just turn around and fire. Hold strong, men. I don't know if my rear is gonna hold. Might collapse down on purpose. Yep, I'm going to. I'm gonna collapse this unit down. I'm gonna do it here on purpose too. I'm gonna collapse it down to here. Taking a beating in the middle right now. retreat on purpose here, and then we'll be on the move. Like that. Exactly what I want. And a lion. You're beating. Losing men. Retreat, good sir. Advance. All right, we're gonna start cutting down brigades now. Like I said, we're gonna run out of ammo before this battle's even done. What would I say? We're already running out of ammo. Fishbowl with Paxton's brigade. He's getting cut to pieces. We're not gonna force sharpshooters for the sharpshooters. We're not going to give an intense chase. We don't have the ammo for it. Yeah, it's just the U.S. sharpshooters. Took that gap. We took 2,000 casualties. They took 9,500, and they still outnumber us. So... still outnumber us by another 2,000. We wounded 7,000 of them, so that's not like a huge hit. They're missing 1,000. Oh, that's the one that's not there. Briggs Attachment, the Loyal Lincoln Volunteers to 1,300. Okay. Look at that for the 2nd U.S. Sharpshooters. Okay. I do need to fix divisions in that. I'm going to make sure all my divisions aren't screwed up. Colonel Reno has become famous and inspiration for his men. We lost 2,000, they lost 95. Wow. Okay. It'll take a little bit to load. Where is State Guard fleeing in panic? Didn't have any issues. OBS is kind of wigging out a little bit. There you go. He was kind of still lagging behind with that. I wonder if there's any skips in this, because I am using OBS on one computer now. So. Or is this? Artillery. Of. First division. Jersey Militia, 1st Division. Free. First, second, artillery division. Have. Go. Sure, all of these they are. What's the Ninth Corps? First Division. Army, it's going to be Army of the Gulf, get there, 1st Division, 2nd Division, couple cav here, 1 cav for Grant. Okay. There's that. They attacked us over here in St. Louis. At this point, we are going to push to Jefferson City. What do the lines look like? I think we push to pop up to Jefferson City and push down the spring. Here. Got depot. Or let's construct. Oh, here. Bert. Get over here. We're gonna construct play depot right outside. Azo supply here. Do we have depots? We have a supply depot there. To make it easier, also make a supply depot north up there, and that's going to be Ganondorf Valley. Push if we need to. We're going to go over here, and then we're going to think about coming down there in the Keys. Stage at the Keys. And probably hit this fort. And use it as a staging point. If need be. Okay, so we are good across the board. We are actually behind them in men fielded. Import treaties. Raids, battles, and weapon exports. Lower availability. Okay. Do I have better... only have Springfields I could really go for. Alright guys, well I'm gonna end the episode here. Kind of figured out the issues, but hey, they are recruiting like no other right now. Jesus! That's gonna be 50,000 right here. Are you, you gotta be, wow. Okay, that's gonna be difficult to deal with. Well, no, we got 100,000 coming, so it's not the end of the world, but Jesus. We need to get the actual recruiting of men to be more productive. At this point, I think this might be... yeah, this will be the Army of the Gulf here. Maybe another do need another corps to come down here and sit with about 10,000 men, maybe? I don't know. This is going to be difficult. Figure out. Flying flotilla sounds good, so let's go over to the Outer Banks. There's like one where I can go like, that's definitely a bigger one. Love to see. Alright guys, so thank you all for joining me. Go ahead and hit that like button below. We had our first battle. The Confederates fought us at St. Louis. We came out on top. We still have a bunch of casualties that will be taken in, though. At about 2,000. Still recruiting the Missouri State Guard. Still doesn't have their full 47,000. We don't have our full 35,000. So, hey, it's a hit or miss. We are creating some jumping points to go into Kentucky. Still got to go into Alabama. Montgomery's the capital. We're invading Confederacy. We haven't, I don't think that win has registered yet. Maintain support above 60. So, we won then, capture 10 forts. West Virginia is going to be one. Cut the Confederacy in half. Get a hold of Memphis, Vicksburg, Baton Rouge, New Orleans. Win 3 consecutive land battles, win 3 naval battles, and win a major land battle. I don't think that was considered a major land battle, but we are definitely having some issues. Want to auto-manage this? Need artillery piece. Get a decent amount of arms. That works. Can we, for example, just level stuff up? Like, no. But are we not? We're not getting corporate taxes right now. No, we don't get it until 3. The Revenue Act. Okay. So yeah, go ahead and leave a comment below if you want me to change a unit to something you want. We already have one, so go ahead and leave those below. We're going to be in what I would consider a cold buildup. But this men fielded by the Confederacy is the thing that kinda scares me. Really, in the West, they haven't taken Fort Sumter yet, which is weird. They haven't moved over to take Fort Pickens. So we're just building up around DC, and I figure we're gonna have a massive battle over here at some point. I think if we come in with the Mountain Department, we defeat the Army of the Northwest. we get the West Virginia. You maybe move this one down at the Army of the Shenandoah. And maybe we have a crazy crazy fight on our hands. 53. Jeez. Only 29. I only have half there. I only have a quarter there. I'll have all of first core. Yeah, guys. Don't forget to also subscribe. It's going to be a long, long episode. So thank you all for joining me, guys. And I will see you guys next time. Later.